Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's look at printing a section of a numbers spreadsheet. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So a very common question I get is, how do I print just a section of a spreadsheet in Mac Numbers? A lot of people previously used Microsoft Excel, and Excel allows you to set a print area and then just print that area of a spreadsheet. So taking a look here in Numbers, one of the things we have to acknowledge about Numbers is that it's fundamentally different than Excel. In Numbers, you have a document which has multiple sheets in it. In this case, this one has a budget sheet and a transaction sheet. And a sheet is like a canvas. It's just a large white space where you could add all sorts of different things. In this case, there's a text box, another text box, there's a chart here, another chart, and there's a table here. And a table is what we usually think of in Excel as a spreadsheet. So we have five different elements here just laid out on the canvas of this sheet. Excel is very different in that a sheet goes edge to edge, just cells. You can see there is no white space here and there are no multiple tables. You have columns, you've got rows, and it stretches as far as you want in this sheet. Even spreadsheets that seem to have multiple elements really don't. Here you could see, well, there's some charts and what look like different tables, but in fact they're not. You could see here there are columns across the top, and each one of these things is a cell or group of cells in a column and a row. So everything has to be designed to fit in with the rows and columns here if you want to have multiple things on the same sheet. With Numbers, I could just add as many tables as I want. I could create another table here and I could stick it wherever I want. I can make it a different size, different shape. I can make the columns different widths and heights and everything. You have maximum flexibility. But with that flexibility comes an issue when you try to print, because you can't just simply say, oh, I only want to print a section of this, because it doesn't really make sense when you have multiple elements on the screen. However, that doesn't stop people from wanting to print just a portion of what they see on the screen. So let's take a look at some strategies. Looking at the second sheet here is just a long list of transactions. So this is a little similar to what you might use in Excel. And here you may just want to print a section of this. So how can you do that? Let's say you just wanted to print the first 20 rows here. So I could select this row here by clicking on the number to the left. I can shift click and select this row. So I've selected here now the first 20 rows. Now how do I print just that? Well, there's no way to do it with just Numbers, but there's a helper tool that comes with your Mac that can be used in all sorts of different ways. It's called Preview. And using Preview you can do this fairly quickly. So here's what you do. All you're going to do with this selected is copy. So edit copy or just Command C. Now let's launch Preview. I can do it here with Spotlight, or you might have it in your dock already. So with Preview launched, and you can see I'm running it up here, I can go to File and you can see New from Clipboard is the default for new. Matter of fact, Command N will get you there. When I do that, I get a little document here that's exactly what I selected in Numbers. Numbers and Preview work together so that it could send the selection from Numbers into Preview and give you a nice little area to print out. Now for most of us, printing actually means saving as a PDF. But at this point, when you're in Preview, it is a PDF. So all you need to do is save, and you'll be saving this out as a PDF file wherever you want it. Or if you actually do want to print to paper, you can just go print here and print it out. So this could be fairly quick, and it works with just about any selection in Numbers. So let's go back to the first spreadsheet here. I can click inside this sheet here, and I can click the little circle here to the upper left, or you can use the trick where you do Select Parent, and now I've selected that whole table. Command C, Launch Preview, Command N. Now I've got that table in there all by itself, and I could print. You can even include other things in it. So for instance, I can do these charts here, although charts print as bitmaps, so they don't look as smooth as printing out the text in a table. So if I select this, Command C, then Preview, then Command N, it works, but if I zoom in, you could see the pixels. Now what happens if I just want to print a section of this, like say these rows right here? Well, I can do Command C, and then switch to Preview, Command N, and I'll get those rows. But what if I want the header row as well? Well, if you try to select that, I'm going to hold the Command key down and select the first row. You can see I've got the first row selected and then rows 12 through 21. Now I'm going to do Command C and then Preview, Command N. I get the header row and I get just the rows I selected and everything else is blank, which is nice that it's not showing those. But I don't want these blank rows there. So here's what you can do. You could simply use the hide function in Numbers to do this. So instead of selecting the ones I want to print, I'm going to go and hide a bunch of rows. So let me go and select this row to this row here. Shift click to select that. And then I can go to Table, Hide Rows. And then let's go and select a bunch of other rows here from 22 all the way down to the end. Shift click to select those. I can also click on the little down arrow here and I can select hide selected rows. So now I've got just what I want to print. Let me click the circle here to select the entire table. Copy, preview, Command N, and now I get exactly what I want. Back here in Numbers I can just use Edit Undo or Command Z to undo the first hide and undo the second hide. Or I could go to Table and say Unhide All Rows to get back to where I was. So you do a little bit of prep work, then you can go to Print through Preview, and then you undo that prep work to get back to the whole table. Now you can also use filters for this. So for instance, if I just wanted to print things that were in the travel category here, I could click here at the top column and say Quick Filter, Show Rows Containing and Travel, and that's all I've got there. Now when I select this whole table, Copy, Preview, New, I get exactly that. Then back here I can click here, go to Quick Filter and turn this off, or I could simply go to Edit, Undo, or Command Z to get rid of the filter. Here's another strategy people like to use. Create another sheet with what you want to print. So I'm going to select this whole table here and copy it. And then I'm going to go and hit the plus button here to create a new sheet. Let's delete this table here. Paste in a copy of that previous table. Since that was the only table on that sheet, I could have actually gone here and just hit duplicate to actually make a copy of that sheet. Since this is a copy, I could go and do what I want. I can select some of these rows here and then click here to delete the selected rows. I could get rid of a column that I don't need. I can shrink a column if maybe it won't fit on the page otherwise. Do what I need here and then go Command P to print this. And when I'm done, I can then go and delete this temporary sheet that I created. Now if you want something a little more permanent, something where you're always printing some rows and never printing others, you can always add a column and filter by that column. So I'm going to click here, add a new column after, and call this one Print. And then I'm going to double click on the column head there so I select all the regular cells. I'm going to set the cell format to checkbox. And basically the idea is anything checked will print. So I can check a bunch of these different columns here. I'm going to create a filter here, and the filter is going to be anything that's true. So you can see I only see the rows that are checked. And then the next thing I want to do is hide this column. And now I go to print and I only see the rows that are checked off. If I want to change those, I need to go here and unhide that column there and also turn the filter off. And now I can play around with these checkboxes and then turn the filtering on again, hide this column to print again. And also another problem people have is they can't see what area is going to be printed until they hit Command P. And then you could see it. Well, it's actually really easy to hit Command P and then to get out of here Command period. Command P, Command period. So you can see how quickly you can get through it. So let's say I wanted to print those checkboxes there, but I want it to fit on a page. I could look at this and say, well, you know what, I could probably shrink this description column a little bit. Command period. Let's go and shrink this column here. Command P. Nope, not enough. Command period. Let's shrink this category column a bit. Command P. Still not enough. Let's go and shrink the print column. Command P. Ah, now it all fits in. So you can see how quickly I can switch between these two modes here and make adjustments. So there are some different printing strategies for you. Which one you choose depends upon your specific situation. For instance, copying and pasting into Preview works best when there are only a limited number of rows that are going to fit on a single page. Usually it's got to be 200 rows or less, although anything more than 100 rows, the print gets really small. If you need to print really often, it's best to design your spreadsheet from the very beginning for printing. So use Command P, Command period to go back and forth. Design your entire spreadsheet around the PDF or printout you want to produce so that you don't have to go through any extra steps every time you want to print. And remember, it's always easy to experiment with number spreadsheets. Just duplicate the file, then take the duplicate and play around with it. Maybe redesign it so that it looks better when you create a PDF or print. And if you decide that you've headed in the wrong direction, you can get rid of that copy, go back to your original, make another copy, and try again. Experimentation is how you're going to be able to get your ideal spreadsheet. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.